Welcome to Grab and Go Info. S-Learner is a meta-learner uplift model that uses a single machine learning model to estimate the individual-level causal treatment effect. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use the Python package CausalML to build S-Learner. We will cover how to implement S-Learner using the Python package CausalML, how to make individual treatment effect and average treatment effect estimation using S-Learner, how to check S-Learner feature importance, how to interpret an S-Learner uplift model using SHAP. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install CausalML for synthetic dataset creation. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. Seaborn is for visualization. LGBM regressor, BaseS regressor, and XGB regressor are for the machine learning model training. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the S-Learner uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the CausalML Python package, we created a dataset with 5 features, 1 treatment variable, and 1 continuous outcome variable. After that, using value counts on the treatment variable, we can see that out of 1,000 samples, 512 units received treatment and 488 did not receive treatment. Finally, we get the true average treatment effect by taking the mean of the true individual treatment effect. The true average treatment effect is about 0.5. In step 3, we will use the S-Learner to estimate the average treatment effect. The Python CausalML package provides 2 methods for building S-Learner models. LRS regressor is a built-in ordinary least squares S-Learner model that comes with the CausalML package. BaseS regressor is a generalized method that can take an existing machine learning models from packages such as Sclearn and XGBoost, and run S-Learners with those models. To estimate the average treatment effect using LRS regressor, we first initiate the LRS regressor, then get the average treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound using the estimate 8 method. We can see that the estimated average treatment effect is 0.65, which is 0.15 higher than the true average treatment effect. To estimate the average treatment effect using BaseS regressor, we first initiate the BaseS regressor, then get the average treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound using the estimate 8 method. Besides passing in the covariates, the treatment variable, and the outcome variable, we need to specify return psi equals true to get the confidence interval for the estimated average treatment effect. We can see that the estimated average treatment effect is 0.47, which is 0.03 lower than the true average treatment effect. The results show that using the BaseS regressor in combination with XGBoost produced a much more accurate estimation for the average treatment effect. In step 4, we will use the S-Learner to estimate the individual treatment effect. Since the S-Learner model of XGB regressor with BaseS regressor produced better estimation, we will continue with this model for the individual treatment effect. The method fitpredict produces the estimated individual treatment effect. From the first 5 results, we can see that the treatment has a positive impact on some individuals and a negative impact on some other individuals. If the confidence interval for the individual treatment effect is needed, we can use bootstrap by specifying the bootstrap number, bootstrap size, and setting return psi equals true. The output gives us both the estimated individual treatment effect and the estimated upper and lower bound for each individual. We can take the mean of the estimated individual treatment effect to get the average treatment effect. We can see that the average treatment effect value of 0.47 is the same as what we estimated in step 3 using the estimate 8 method. In step 5, we will check the S-Learner feature importance. The Python CausalML package provides 2 methods for calculating feature importance. Auto works on a tree-based estimator. It uses the estimator's default feature importance. If no tree-based estimator is provided, it falls back to the LGBM regressor, and gain is the importance type. Permutation works on any estimator. It permutes a feature column and calculates the decrease in accuracy. The feature importance is ordered based on the magnitude of the decrease in accuracy. When the sample size is large, downsampling is suggested. Both methods are based on a machine learning model, where the dependent variable is the individual treatment effect, and the independent variables are the features of the model. Get importance is the function to get the feature importance values. X takes in the feature matrix. Tau takes in the individual treatment effect. Normalize equals true normalizes the importance value by the sum of importance. It only works for method equals auto. Features equals feature names prints out the feature names and the outputs. Method specifies whether to use auto or permutation for the feature importance calculation. From the method equals auto output, we can see that x1 is the most important feature, x5 is the least important feature, and x2, x3, and x4 importance values are similar. All the importance values add up to 1 because we specified normalize equals true. We can also visualize the feature importance using the plot importance function. When calculating the feature importance using the permutation method, we need to add a random state number to make the results reproducible. From the method equals permutation output, we can see that x1 is the most importance feature, x5 is the least important feature, and x2, x3, and x4 importance values are similar. This is consistent with the auto method results. However, the feature importance order for x3 and x4 are different. The auto method shows that x3 is the second most important feature, while the permutation method shows x4 is the second most important feature. We can also visualize the feature importance using the plot importance function. In step 6, we will interpret the S-Learner model using SHAP. The Sharply values are calculated based on a machine learning model, where the dependent variable is the individual treatment effect and the independent variables are the features of the model. Plot SHAP values is the function to visualize SHAP values. X takes in the feature matrix. Tau takes in the individual treatment effect. Features equals feature names prints out the feature names and the outputs. The SHAP plot includes both the feature importance and the feature impacts. The y-axis is the list of features ordered from the most important to the least important. The x-axis is the SHAP value, representing how each feature impacts the model output. The color of the dots represents the feature values. Blue indicates low values, and red indicates high values. The overlapping dots are jittered, which helps us to see the distribution of each feature. For example, from the SHAP plot we can see that x1 is the most important feature. High x1 values affect the predictions in a positive direction and low x1 values affect the precisions in a negative direction. The SHAP dependence plot shows the feature's marginal impact on model predictions. The Python CausalML has a function called plot SHAP dependence. Treatment group takes in the treatment group value. Our dataset has 0 for the control group and 1 for the treatment group, so we set treatment group equals 1. Feature IX is the feature index for the SHAP dependence plot. Since the index starts with 0, feature IX equals 3 indicates that we would like to plot the SHAP dependence for x4. X is the feature matrix. Tau is the individual treatment effect. Interaction IX is the feature index for the color. Setting interaction IX equals 3 means that the color is based on the feature value for x4. Features equals feature names prints out the feature names and the outputs. The plot shows that higher x4 values correspond to lower SHAP values, and lower x4 values correspond to higher SHAP values. We can also set interaction IX equals auto to pick the strongest interaction feature automatically. We can see that x3 is picked as the color scheme automatically for the feature x4. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about the Uplift models, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.